volume of data. Let us assume if somebody is good at numbers, they need to sharpen their skills in mathematical reasoning, data interpretation, logical reasoning. Somebody who can memorize a large volume of data and they can do the application of the same. See, there is no direct question in the NET examination. You should understand the concept. You should apply it. Nobody will ask you what is communication, correct? Which among the following definitions may be called as communication? That may be a question. Which of the following is the example of learning? That may be a question. So you should learn the concept. For that, you should know your own strength and weakness. If I am not good at memorizing a large volume of data, I should not focus on those areas, such as in paper one you take, it is environmental studies, let us say higher education, where the volume of syllabus is heavy. See, for succeeding in paper one, you should be master in 8 units and remaining 2 units, that is up to you whether to touch it or not. I guarantee you that you clear paper one with colorful results. And you should have your own study plan or lesson plan. Every day, paper one requires minimum 2 hours of studying or coaching. And paper two requires 3 hours. A fast learner may require 3 to 4 hours a day to prepare NET examination, considering the 6 months time to prepare for the examination, right? In case of slow learner, it may take even 6 hours per day. See, I agree with you that we are all having college life, or you may be a research scholar, you may be doing a research, or you may be doing a business, whatever it may be, but try to devote some time for this. See, the first and foremost mistake everybody makes is they started studying from the date of getting hall ticket or from the date of getting the application. See, I applied for the examinations today, so I should start preparation from today. And in between your preparation, if you are taking a break, let us say you prepared for a month and you are taking a break, let us say 15 days break, you go to other state and you attend your friend's marriage. What happens now? Your learning speed comes down. Try to understand. When you are not doing the continuous and consistent learning, your learning speed automatically comes down. So always stick with your own study plan. Difference between preparing methodology of MCQ question and DQ question. See, DQ is descriptive question paper. So far, whatever you did till your MPhil or PhD, or even your PG, it's a type of descriptive paper. You write paragraphs, side headings, presentable manner, you will get good marks. But that skill set will not help you to crack a competitive examination like NET or SET. Here, you should be conceptually strong and you should know how to apply the knowledge. Okay, time management I discussed already. Tips to study in a systematic way. See, every 1 hour once you should study your, you should change your subject matter. For example, today I am going to study for 4 hours. Okay, let it be morning 2 hours, or the night, or the evening 2 hours. That depends on you. I don't ask you to sit for 4 to 5 hours continuously. But if you are sitting for, let us say, 2 hours continuously, you should change your subject matter at least 3 subjects within 2 hours. For example, the first 40 minutes, I study teaching aptitude. 10 minutes, I take rest. Next to 40, 45 minutes, I study mathematical reasoning. Take some rest. Next to 30, 35 minutes or 40 minutes, paper to some subject matter. This keeps your brain active. Clear? See, our classroom session long lasts for 50 minutes, right? Any idea why it is 50 minutes classroom session? Can anybody explain why the classroom session is for 50 minutes or 45 minutes in colleges or schools, wherever it is? Any idea about it?
time taken to retain is only so much, sir.
What is the attention span of the student?
As per the school, if it's a 40 minute, it will be between 25 to 30 or 20 to 30.
Mariamal ma'am and Redmi, for others, I am audible. So kindly check your audio and network settings. School, it is 40. Attention span is 40. You mean that you
no, teach sir.
For 40 minutes, he listens and grabs for 40 minutes. It is not so.
No, sir. That's not correct. Yes.
Yeah.
The attention span is 20 to 25 minutes.
Very good, very good. Professor Elsa Daniel, it is 15 to 20 minutes, not more than that. That's why I said, don't study anything more than that. 40 minutes, that's enough to read something, grab something, or take notes, scenes, whatever. Okay. As I said, you need to have a consistent and continuous preparation. Let us take an example. You go to a gym for a month, okay, and you get some flexibility in your muscles, correct? Let us assume that you take 15 days break, then go back and do the same exercise. Your body muscles will not support you. Am I right? In the same way, you learn for a month, you train your brain in a particular subject matter for a month, and you take a break of 15 days or a week, your brain neurons will forget whatever you learned. You come back to the square one. See, 1 or 2 days due to health issue, due to unavoidable circumstances, you are taking leave from studies, that is okay. And always practice previous year questions, because frequently asked questions are there. I mean, the questions are not repeating, but the question pattern, that is repeating. Okay, forming a study group WhatsApp, that is there already. Let's move on. And try to use the memory techniques whenever you are going to process a large volume of theoretical data. Let us take the case of higher education. Okay, if that is the case, you should have some memory techniques that we will see in the session, not now. Okay, post preparation phase. Again, majority of NET aspirants will commit mistake here. These people study till the examination date, they keep on studying books. But that is not the procedure. Here, your preparation should be 50% and practice should be 50%. Before getting into the real examination, you should attempt at least 5 question papers of paper 1 and paper 2 to get yourself strengthening to face the examination. This is the blunder error we make every time. People keep on studying till the last date of examination. See, this is not a descriptive examination. This technique will not work out. So once you complete your syllabus, conceptualize, you are strong. Take tests, apply it. That gives you learning. So once you analyze the test by unit wise, you will know where you fall and where you stand. You know what is your weakness, what is your strength. This helps you to crack the examination. For example, across the 5 or 10 paper 1 test you have taken, it is shown that you are not good at logical reasoning. Your logical reasoning scores are always less, 1 or 2 only correct in the particular section. There will be 5 questions from logical reasoning. So the every test you look at, only 1 or 2 questions you are able to answer out of 5 questions. What does it mean? You are not good at the particular subject matter. So what is the knowledge you get here? You should not touch the subject matter in the examination at first. If the first question is from logical reasoning, then you should skip it and move on. In the last moment, if you are having sufficient time, in the last moment, if you are having sufficient time, then you can come back and attend the same unit where you are weak. Clear? So attempting test gives broader view about what you are capable of. Try to understand it. Nobody takes tests. That's the problem. Even in the last semester, we have conducted even free test also. Okay. So examination phase. Every unit will have a trick to solve. Every question will have a clue to notice. So there will be a grammatical match you can see. There will be a verbal association you can see. There is a logical guesswork you can do. It is not a blind guess. Mostly the answer will be right. Okay, preparation strategy. When you attend more and more question papers from the previous year, you will get understanding about the examiner's perspective. What questions they usually ask. See, I guarantee you, if you solved 20 question papers of paper 1 and paper 2, okay, you can understand the examiner's perspective. And confidence boosters. The first 20 minutes of the examination will decide your results. How? For example, in the first 20 minutes, I attempted 15 questions because one question, 1 minute, right? Roughly attempted 15 questions. So now my brain says, whatever the 15 question you attempted, that is correct up to my knowledge. So what happens to the confidence level now? You attempted 15 questions. Suddenly your brain says all the 15 questions were right. What happens to the confidence level? Can anybody answer?
It increases, sir.
It will definitely increase. At the same time, you attempted 15 questions and your brain says all the 15 questions were doubtful. What happens? Confidence level comes down. So when the confidence level goes up, the remaining questions with the positive attitude, you can attempt correctly. If you are getting this negative attitude, that is less confidence to move forward, though you know the subject matter, you may tick the wrong answer. This is called confidence booster. So once you open the question paper, you should attempt those questions which you know very well. Though there is no negative marking, don't waste your time on all the questions. Okay, attempting the questions in the logical order. So nowadays in paper 1 it is okay, they don't jumble much, but in paper 2 we cannot say that because the units are jumbled, mixed questions they are giving, selecting the right answer and eliminating the wrong one. So first of all, we should know the technique of how to eliminate the wrong one. For some questions, you should go from question to option. For some question, you should go from options to question, correct? Then this paragraph to question and question to paragraph is typically meant for reading comprehension. Whenever you are attempting reading comprehension, many people say that, sir, the answer is in front of me, but I am not able to attempt it. What could be the possible reason? Because you are adopting a wrong methodology, that is traditional way. When you are studying in school, teacher used to say this, correct? Read the paragraph twice, then go to the question. Am I right? But in case of competitive examination, you should read the question first. For example, first question in the reading comprehension, read it, get back to the passage, try to search the answer. What happens here? There is something called selective reading happens. You don't read every sentence here. Your brain automatically scans the sentences instead of reading it. So automatically it stops where the answer is. If you're having doubt in this technique, you can try it and tell me. Take a reading comprehension passage today. Read the question. Come back to the passage. Your brain will quickly find the answer. Right? So questions like assertion reasoning, strong or weak arguments, match the following. These are the repeated models and other things are there. And you take this thing. Post-examination phase. As soon as examination completed, people are getting free, stress-free, thinking that they may pass. But don't be like that. Keep on preparing. If you lose by one mark, the next examination will be a cakewalk. If you lose practice till the result come, let us say the examination date and the result days is 15-20 days. Till the result come, if you take rest, then again your learning phase goes to the square one. So keep on preparing till you see the results on the certificate. So this is the question pattern. You know it very well. First paper, 50 questions, 2 marks. So totally 100 questions. 100 marks. Second paper, 100 questions, 2 marks, totally 200 marks. The total time given is 3 hours. There's no break in between. So this is the result analysis of NTN NET June 2020. Totally 8.6 lakhs people applied, out of which 5.26 people appeared. Okay, out of them, only 40,986 plus 6,171 people got qualified. And this is your JRF score. This is your assistant professor score. So only this 47,000 plus aspirants are your competitors if you are preparing in the right way. It is not that your competition is with 8.6 lakh people. It is always with only 50,000 people, not more than that. Okay, so why we should take a training? Why we should go for an online training? See, paper one, we planned for 60 hours. Paper two, we planned for 60 hours. 60 hours means it is not constant. It will increase but not decrease. Got it? Paper two may go for 70 hours. Paper two is 60. It may go for 78 hours. Paper one also. It all depends. So minimum hours, what we are committing is 60 hours for paper one and 60 hours for paper two. In case, if it is a physical classroom setup, if you are absent for a particular class, you will not get anything. Let us say if you are absent for 3 days, you can get recordings from us, but that is not possible with a physical classroom setup. No trainer will come and take again. The classroom methodology will be lecturing and discussion. It is not a monologue, it is dialogue. It is like a participatory learning. So I explain something, I take viewpoints from you, the class goes like that. It is a discussion session. It is not entirely a lecturing one. And brainstorming session. Okay, we will give a topic every week. So there will be a brainstorming session happens online. So conceptual wise, these two things make you strong: lecturing, discussion, and brainstorming. But all those things you will not get in the physical classroom setup. Try to understand. Doubt clearing session 24/7 in WhatsApp. If you are having any doubt in the concept or any question, take a photograph, send it in the WhatsApp. So within 24 hours, I assure you, your doubts will be clear. And one-to-one mentoring will be possible if you join the classes. Soft copy of notes, question and answer bank will be given. See, why soft copy of notes? See, I ask people to go through the notes and you have to prepare your handy notes from the soft copy of notes. Hard copy of notes I can give if you want, but again, that adds with the cost. The Xerox cost and the binding cost, courier cost, you have to bear. There is no issue in giving hard copies. Okay. For the cost, for the price we worked out, soft copy would be the most possible one. In case if you need a hard copy, then that would be extra charges that you are going to pay. And the unlimited online test series. So this will be given in the month of May once we complete the syllabus. So once you are conceptually strong, you are going to take the test. But I prefer online test series should be minimum, offline test series should be maximum. Any idea why? Online test, you should not take many. Any idea? See, offline test, you will be having one question, four options, correct? Online question, once you answered it, the question moves away. You cannot see that. So how do you review the question? See, my advice is sit with the question paper. For example, 3 hours you take. Let us assume you completed the syllabus. You take 3 hours. You must be free from kids, pets, and mobile. Okay. Take an online test. 3 hours, it will be over. And there is no scope for reviewing the question paper. It will just show you the score, correct? Nothing else. But in case of offline test, the question paper is with you. So once you complete the test, you are having the answer keys. You can check what error you made. And whenever you go for a question paper approach, you should complete the question paper on time. Let us say I take 1 hour for paper one. I am able to complete only 25 questions. It is okay. Don't take another hour to complete 50 questions. If you are strict with time, then the speed will automatically increase, but gradually increase. Okay. So whenever you complete a test, sit with the question paper, that is offline test, hard copy of the book, sit with the question paper. There will be one right answer and remaining three options are the right. For the remaining three options, you should try to know the meaning. So that when you complete one question paper, okay, paper 150 questions, paper 200 questions, correct? 150 questions, approximately, there are 600 options, correct? Approximately, there are 600 options. 150 questions into four. Each question will be having four options, right? In that way. So minimum 500 concepts you learn from one question paper review. This can be done only through hard copy of question papers. Or soft copy if you are having it is okay. But not online test series. Online test series will be helpful to maintain your time, to give you practice. That's it. So this is the student feedback. You can go through it once. So this is what I am sharing you directly from the website. You can check out here. From this website, I'm sharing this. So I received around 300 reviews like this because I have been teaching people from 2014 onwards. Okay, this is our results. From the year 2017, I started taking private classes. So from 2017 is here, 2018, 19 list and the 20 list. So these are all the students who learned through my guidance and the classes. Okay, let us understand how the question would be. This is from Commerce question paper, June 2020. And a particular statistics in a research situation is evidently declared to be significant. Which of the following decision will be considered turnable? So it means there is a significant relationship exists. That's what they are given indirectly. When a significant relationship exists, we reject null hypothesis, we accept alternate hypothesis, answer A and B. Clear? And whatever we do with offline classes, online classes will also be interactive like this. 1 minute. So answer is for A and B. Second question, there will be two statements given, right? Read the first statement. How to solve questions like this? First one is concept-based question, which is very easy to clear. How to solve questions like this? Statement-based question. SWAYAM is an initiative of Government of India aims at providing affordable and quality education to the citizens. It means that is correct, right? First statement is 100% correct. So when first statement is correct, I can rule out the fourth option. Correct? Fourth option is not the answer because it says first statement is incorrect. And I can rule out the second option also because it says statement one and statement two are false. I know already statement one is true. So answer lies between one and three. This is how we need to eliminate the wrong option. You have seen in the previous slide, right? How to eliminate the wrong option. This is the methodology. SWAYAM aims to promoting education and health of adolescent girls. No, that's wrong. Correct? So statement one is correct and two is false. This is the best way to solve the question. But what people usually do, they will read statement one and statement two and they will evaluate correct option one, correct option two, three, four, like this. It takes your time. Okay, look at this question. Very simple question for mathematical ability. See, usually people say max is tough or data interpretation is tough. I don't say that because I come from commerce background. I trained myself in mathematics. It takes 2 to 3 months if you are willing. So a shopkeeper sells an item at a discount of 40%. The item listed price is 1,500. That is the market price. That is MRP. 1,500. 1,500, 40% discount is 600, correct? He still makes 20% profit. What is the original cost? So when he is selling for 900 rupees, he makes 20% profit. So 900 divided by 120 into 100, that is 750. Answer is 2. Okay, this is a coding type question. So A, B, C, A, C, D, something like this will be given. So don't waste your time on all these things. Whenever coding question is given, there is a technique. Maximum option appearing in which code? For example, I take A. A is appearing here and here. 2 occurrences. B is appearing 3 times. I need to check out B. What is the question? Key behavior contributing to effective teaching. This is the clue in this question. Okay. Key behavior contributing to effective teaching. Okay, what is B? Lesson clarity is correct. Sorry, B is instructional variety, that is correct. So 4 is ruled out. Without B, 4 is the wrong option. I ruled it out. Then I check A appeared twice. Lesson clarity. Yes, that is also the effective teaching behavior. So wherever A and B comes, that is the answer. So answer lies between 1 and 2. I rule out the third option. Now it is ABD or ABC. Using student ideas and contribution. Is that effective teaching behavior? See, it is accepted that you are using the student idea, but that is not effective teaching behavior. Try to understand. Then C is ruled out. So option comes with C. That is option number 2. That is ruled out. ABD is the answer. See, here I didn't read A, B, C, D, E, all these things. I read only A, B and C. I am able to give answer for the question. This way you can save the time. So again, assertion reasoning question, many of you make an error. So assertion, typically this type of question in paper 2 gives more weightage. Random access memory is volatile and stores data program currently in use. True or false? RAM is a volatile memory and it stores data currently in use. That is correct. So A is correct. When A is correct, fourth option is ruled out. Correct. Remaining things are fine. Now read the reason as a statement. Don't read it as a reason. Read the reason as a statement. RAM is a storage medium that retains its contents even after the supply of power turned off. It is not so. Whenever you switch off the PC, RAM forgets everything. Correct. So R is false. So answer lies in the third option. A is true, R is false. Questions like this, you should read assertion first, check with the four options, eliminate the wrong one, then reason, eliminate the wrong option, then move forward. This is the methodology. People usually read assertion and reason put together, then come to the four option. That takes a lot of time. Okay, now the session is open for Q&A. Even though the session cuts somewhere, then I will put another session. That is not an issue. Any questions from your side? I need a feedback about this class also. Last 5 minutes. If you want, I can extend the session. That is not an issue. You can open up your mic or you can use your chat window to give feedback about the session. Or any other questions about the examination? See, there are 28, 30 people in the group. Okay, I received one chat message. Sir, don't send the message to me. Rajamani, sir, you can send the message to the entire crowd. Let people see. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Very useful session. Very nice session. Okay. Thank you, Nandini ma'am and Rajamani, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Maria ma'am. Nice presentation. We will definitely, ma'am. Russia Beham ma'am, very useful session. Thank you. Anybody needs one more, some more time to discuss? Inform me. 3 more minutes are there. Yeah, blueprint is available for paper 1, but paper 2, we cannot rely on the blueprint. Sindhuja, ma'am, I hope I explained your query. Yeah, I will give the syllabus, no problem. Anita, ma'am, I will give the syllabus, no problem. Nazima, ma'am, thank you. Elsa, Daniel, ma'am, thank you. So 2 more minutes. If you want the session to be extended, I will give one more meeting. Diva sir, syllabus I will send you in the group, no problem. Paper 1 syllabus I will put it in the group. Sir, I give coaching for only NTA, biochemistry falls under CSIR. If you are going to attempt for SET, then you can join the training only for paper 1. Biochemistry we are not handling. We are giving you commerce, management and yoga. Thank you, Anita Raghul, ma'am. Thank you very much, sir. It is very satisfactory. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Sanofer. Thank you, Vengadesan, sir. Jalina, ma'am. Karin, ma'am. Okay, 1 more minute. See, regarding the fees, if you are having any concern, you can reach me in my WhatsApp.
Are so any other queries? When are we planning to schedule the classes, sir? When are we planning to begin the classes?
Classes begin from mid-January, ma'am. Thank you, Varshini, ma'am.
Sir, is the paper 1 classes every day or how is it scheduled, sir?
Paper 1 classes every day, night 9 to 10 p.m. Night, okay? 9 to 10 p.m. Paper 2 is scheduled on weekends.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
And timing, sir?
Weekends, sir? We will inform you the timing, ma'am. Wait, I will put one more meeting also. This meeting is going to end. I will put one more meeting. Kindly join. Sneha Hari, ma'am, you asked about a publication or book. You should ask in the private window. In the public forum, you should not comment on the particular book. Okay, I will disconnect the call and put one more meeting. You can raise your questions. Stay tuned.